So skin tags are benign, meaning non-cancerous lesions on the skin, and they commonly occur in areas where there are skin folds. So common areas would be areas like the neck, the armpits, or the groin. Skin tags can happen both in men and women, and they are commoner in the older age groups. So if we look microscopically, the skin tags are basically collagen fibers as well as some blood vessels surrounded by a thickened epidermal layer of the skin. There are some risk factors associated with skin tag formation, and these include being obese or patients who have type 2 diabetes, for example. So there are some other skin lesions that can be commonly mistaken for skin tags. Such lesions include things like seborrheic keratosis. So these seborrheic keratosis happen more in sun-exposed areas as well as areas of friction of the skin. The other common lesion that is mixed up for skin tag is warts. Warts are usually because of viral infection of the skin. They usually happen in areas such as the feet, the palms, or in areas where there is compromised epidermis of the skin, like areas of eczema, for example. Treatment of skin tags is generally simple, but bear in mind that skin tags tend to recur at the same area even after treatment. So some techniques that we use to remove skin tags include surgery. Sometimes if a skin tag is big enough, we can actually use a scissors to snip off the skin tag. That's a very simple procedure. In smaller skin tags with not so well defined stalk, we sometimes use lasers to basically burn off the skin tags. These treatments generally carry very, very little downtime, and all the patient needs is a little bit of antibiotic cream after the treatment so that it doesn't get infected, and the area usually heals within about a week or so.